Fire Station 18.
It's called a beacon cache. It's basically a rolling storage box that includes all kinds of information, emergency equipment, and a radio. It's a place for people to get information post-disaster, and it's also a place for people to report life-threatening injuries or significant damage.
We have a pop-up shelter.
We have 48 beacon sites that are geographically distributed throughout the city. Places like parks, school fields, and a few other miscellaneous facilities. I think an important thing to remember is, you know, if you can stay home and you have no reason to leave your house and it's safe to stay there, you should probably just stay there. If you do need more information, then you can approach a beacon. I think one thing you do need to recognize is it can take 24 to 48 hours for these beacon sites to pop up.
We have a lantern, a UHF radio. You'll also see an extra tent top in here. This is the larger first aid kit. There's two of them. This has most of your bulk supplies.
Such as bandages.
Bandages, gloves, trauma dressings, cold packs, space blankets. This is more of the consumables. So we have duct tape, we have respirators, we have, these are eyewear, eye protection. In the event of a large earthquake, the city of Portland might lose the ability to communicate, particularly telephones, cell phones, and email and internet. Beacons are designed to allow people to get information about a disaster and also report damage and a life-threatening situation.
Inside each beacon cache is a simple UHF radio. Those radios are used to speak with nearby fire stations. We have asked amateur radio operators to staff those nearby fire stations, and then they can actually speak with the city's emergency coordination center. This is really low tech. All it is a UHF radio. It's point to point, it's line of sight. It doesn't involve any intermediary equipment, and it allows you at the beacon to speak with a nearby fire station. We did a small scale drill. We tested about a quarter of the beacon program not too long ago. We were able to communicate with all the beacons involved, and we were pretty excited to see that happen. Right now, we've been primarily working with the Portland Neighborhood Emergency Team Program. They're called NETS. They are emergency volunteers for the city.
All right, we're going to lock the wheel.
We are always happy to take on new volunteers for people who want to learn more about the program and potentially help out in an emergency.